champion fighter. He was from Thailand. He participated in the Iron Fist tournament this August. Winning. Hello, Carl Simmons. So tell me. You can sit back down. So tell me, just who are you?
Well, my friends call me Buka the Great, Buka the Flying Pig, and I'm a TIE fighter.
Mm-hmm. So, when you say Muay Thai, and I just want to do this so that our viewers at home can get a more clear definition of what a Muay Thai fight is, what kind of fighting do you do?
I do the type of fighting that will kill people instantly.
I see. Is there a specific name for that?
Iron Fist Muay Thai.
Are there any specific moves that you use?
Well, there is one move I like to use a lot called the Holy Nutcracker. What it is I actually take them by the head and squeeze till their head pops.
Are there any people that have influenced you to become a fighter?
Yes. Well, really, you just have to look into a child's eyes, and that's all the influence you need. There's my great trainer, spiritual trainer, Mr. Miyoto, and physical trainer, Rick. I like to call him Rick the Rolling Thunder.
I better push up! My grandma can do push-ups like that!
What kind of martial arts style are you most proficient in?
Well, I'm proficient in all of them, every single one, but I like to teach him Muay Thai Jitsu.
And what is this Muay Thai Jitsu?
It's a technique that focuses on crushing people's heads and beating their brains.
Can you feel your legs?
No.
Can you feel your eyes?
No.
Well, keep going till you can!
What made you want to become a martial artist?
Well, I just got picked on at school. But mostly because my dad was a martial artist. That's pretty much it.
100 times! I'm not tired yet, he is! Hey! You like Pop-Tarts?
Yes.
Well, so do I! Are you ready?
Yeah.
Punch me in the face!
But, I'll hurt you.
Go! You okay?
My hand's broken.
I'm gonna punch you, you're gonna show them all the blocks I taught you. Ready?
No. Sir, I just ran 500 miles. Can I please have some water?
Sure.
What am I supposed to do?
You will live by your fist and die by your fist. You must punch the water and drink it off your fists. That's right, you're learning. Want some more, buddy?
Yes, please, sir.
Do you think Baku has what it takes to win the Iron Fist tournament?
I'm going to say this once. I want you to write this down when I say it, because I really mean it. I think Buka has absolutely no chance of winning.
When you say spiritual training, what do you mean?
Well, you can just picture this. A little guy like this short, and he sleeps about 23 hours a day, and then that last hour, he actually releases his chi power into my body and spiritually enlightens me.
So where are we going?
We're gonna go get enlightened by my spiritual trainer. This is his room.
do a lot of fighters actually spiritually train themselves? And is there actually a benefit?
That was a stupid question. Of course it benefits them. Gives the family great honor. Just to be with me.
I see. So you're world-renowned then. What kind of credentials do you have?
None at all. I'm underground.
You're underground as in...
No one should know about the Sword of Destiny.
But you realize that once this film is distributed, people will know about the Sword of Destiny. It spiritually enlightens you, and in what way? Does it give you greater focus? Does it make you faster, stronger?
It makes me faster, stronger. Imagine you're strapped to the back of a rhino, running at full speed at a car. It's driving full speed at you, and you're just like, oh my god, what? I don't know. That's kind of what it's like.
Do you believe the Baku has what it takes to win the Iron Fist tournament?
It is in my belief and full understanding that he will in fact lose the tournament.
So, that was the spiritual training, huh?
Yes.
How do you feel?
Spiritified.
You have a lot of young fans out there. Most of them are probably 6 months to 11 years old. Do you have a message for them?
Yeah, I do. You know, kids, what you have to do is you gotta take life by the throat and punch it in the jaw. Punch it, punch it, and just keep punching it over and over and over and over. That's how you deal with life.
Do you have any enemies on the martial arts scene? And if so, what message do you have for them?
Yeah, I actually have one main enemy. He's called Yao the Snake. And the message I have for him is I'm gonna take him. I'm gonna chop off his head with the shovel.
Do you think you have what it takes to win the Iron Fist tournament?
I have more than what it takes to win the Iron Fist tournament. And it's not about the trophy, and it's not about winning first place. It's about the money. You gotta get the money, and then everything else just comes on through. Just comes on through. Just bring it on through, because it just comes on through.
Alright, Mr. Buka the Great, thank you for your time. I'm sure that this interview will be... Oh. I'm sorry. Okay. Say goodbye to all the young viewers at home.